Hi friends, I am Dr. Sharma and I would be discussing the clinical features of urethral trauma. The objectives of this particular talk are to describe the clinical presentation of urethral trauma and to discuss the various fallacies of presenting features of clinical urethral trauma. Now the classical triad which suggests a urethral injury is blood at meatus, failure to void, and a perineal hematoma or a pelvic fracture. Now if these three things are present, it is usually believed that there would be a urethral injury. Now let us see each one of them separately. Blood at meatus. This is not seen in all cases. In fact, it is seen in only 37 to 93% of cases. Now this tends to occur because when there is trauma, there would also be spasm of the bulbospongiosus muscle which is surrounding the urethra, and this leads to expulsion of the blood, causing blood at meatus. This is seen after about an hour after injury. So there are two important things to remember. Though blood at meatus is a classical sign of a urethral trauma, it is not seen in 100% of cases, and whenever it is seen after about an hour after the injury has occurred. A palpable bladder. This occurs because there is spasm of the sphincter, the patient is unable to void, and this classically occurs when there is a posterior urethral injury. Now this will occur if the bladder is full. If the patient is dehydrated, then this cannot occur. Perineal hematoma. This is a butterfly shaped hematoma which is seen because of a straddle injury which affects the bulbar urethra. This is also not seen immediately and is seen after 24 to 48 hours. On clinical examination, in cases of posterior urethral disruptions, we sometimes see what is called as a high riding prostate, because the prostate has been separated from the remaining part of the urethra, it goes up. That is called as a high riding prostate. Though this is a very classical sign of a posterior urethral injury, it is seen in only 34% of cases, which means that 66% of the times of posterior urethral injury, we will not see a high riding prostate. Now 20 to 25% of patients with pelvic ring disruption have their urological injury missed. This is because of lack of physical signs or because of misleading imaging. Hence, to diagnose a urethral injury, keep a high index of clinical suspicion. This is important because blood at meatus doesn't present initially, perineal hematoma will come after only a day or two, and 20 to 25% of the times, because of the lack of physical signs or not having a high index of suspicion or misleading imaging, we are likely to miss a urethral injury. So, having a high index of clinical suspicion, we would diagnose it and then take up investigations to confirm this injury. Thanks friends. For many such videos, log on to admedonline.com.